4K Downloader is the simple solution for downloading high quality videos from YouTube and other social media platforms for use at a later date. You can download the smallest resolutions all the way up to the 4K resolution, including 3D and 360 VR videos. Whether you want to download just the videos, an entire playlist or an entire channel, or if you would just like to do audio MP3s, this program is the one for you. Try it now for free, or if you'd like to get the personal or the pro setup, click on the link down below and continue to support this channel. Hey there and welcome to another Musician Reacts, and today we're doing another video where we're checking into some in the studio workings of artists and just kind of working out what's going on and sharing my kind of viewpoints on that. So today we're checking out the Snoop Dogg in the studio of Katy Perry working on the song California Girls. And this was quite a way back, so what, 10 or 12 years ago or whatever it might have been that it came out. So it's interesting to go back and see it. Now, I love checking out studio footage, sound check footage, stuff like that, so that I love to see how other artists work, how musicians kind of interact in the studio, what their process is, and hopefully share some of that with you on the YouTube. Before we get to that, please make sure to head over to my other channel, Dave Does, for other reactions, collaborations, music stuff in general. So there's lots of stuff on there, and a lot of the older original Musician Reacts channel videos are on there. Please subscribe to both channels to get updates. Also check out the Dave Does Musician Reacts merch store. We've got mugs, we've got t-shirts and all that other stuff. It helps support the channel. And of course we have the Patreon on the Dave Does channel, which supports both channels and keeps them going. So we'll go check, please go check those out. Details in the description down below. Let's count it in. There's a couple of rules I have for this channel. They're gonna come across the screen if they haven't already. And yeah, we'll watch the video. Won't pause it, won't talk over it, but at the end of it, I'll give you kind of thoughts, feedbacks, and discussions. Let's do it. 3, 2, 1, go.
How'd you do?
I heard you were a photo shoot. Thanks for taking
this. Hey, I'm Max Martin. What's going on? What's that?
We have a shrine for you.
That's hard. I need a Joe Cool to be here. With the big cock on the block, huh?
Yeah, the biggest
big
one.
I like that. That's good. I liked it. I liked the way you shrined me up.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay. Sam, why'd you put the scissors next to it? Sam!
Yeah, you gotta put the whole spirit in the building. You know what I mean? I like what I'm hearing. That shit sounds kind of funny.
Play it again from the top.
Yeah.
Alright, check it. Yeah. It's still not done. Let's check.
Yeah, we just had a couple days on it. Everybody was dancing on the dance floor to it after party, and I was like, we're in Los Angeles, and yeah. You put your hands up to Empire State of Mind. We need a response, quick! I know it's been done, but we need one now.
Yeah, you did that. That's hot shit right there.
Thank you.
That is hot shit right there. Let me get that little break. That's what I'm supposed to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
Give me that break. Let me ask the piper to play.
That's loud, or same thing?
Give me that break. Like, give me like 4 bars before we go to that break.
Mm-hmm.
And then like 4 bars after, and just keep that shit looping.
Okay.
I'm where you at right now. I feel that.
I was just like, there needs to be a response. And plus, there isn't a chick that's ever done anything like California Girls style. There's been a lot of guys, and there's been a bunch of bands and stuff, but...
Not individually, a solo female
strong enough
to do that.
Right.
And I will be driving this soul plane straight to the motherfucking West Coast. Let's just hear what it sounds like. Let's try something. That same spot you've been rotating and flipping around in.
tone, tan, fit, and ready. Turn it up, cause it's getting heavy. Wow, wow, West Coast. These are the girls I love the most. I mean the ones, I mean like she's the one. Touch her, kiss her, squeeze her buns. The girl's a freak, she drive a Jeep and live on the beach. I'm okay, I won't play, I love the Bay and I love LA. Venice Beach and Palm Springs. Summertime is everything. Homeboys banging out, all that ass hanging out. Bikini, zucchini, martinis, no weenies, just the king and the queenie. Katy, my lady, look at here, baby. I'm all up on you, cause you representing California. Yeah, holler at me on the dance floor.
Kitty Purry, Snoop Doggy Diggy.
Church. Preach. Tabernacle.
Okay, so Snoop Dogg at the studio with Katy Perry working on California Girls. So, didn't get to see too much of the behind the scenes, which is a shame. But there's one big thing that is pretty much now still a no-no. And you hear about it a lot, it's which is smoking. So smoking in studios is pretty much a no-no. And drinks and so forth anywhere near any of the electronics is a no-no because it's so easy for something to spill. So they didn't have any drinks near them. I would say the smoking thing, there's a couple of reasons behind it. There's a lot of talk about how you get smoke into the desks, into the coyote, or was it coyotes? I can't remember how to pronounce that today. And it can gunk up, because it does, it gives you like a substance in the smoke, so it gunks up the hardware, so you don't really want that. It's harder to clean out. It can mess up resistors inside the mixing desk, etc. So you don't really want that. Also, you get ash drop. So pretty much, I don't know of any studio I've ever gone into where they've said, yes, it's okay to smoke. They always say smoking outside, keep it completely clean. The other thing is these mics don't get sterilized and cleaned afterwards. So if you've got a smoky microphone and you're going quite close up and you don't like the smell of smoke, you're going to have a very smoky smelling microphone. It's not great, and also it dries out. It's bad for your vocals. Now, obviously, from Snoop Dogg, that's his style, that's his sound. So I'm sure he likes that sort of effect. He's getting it from his kind of low end vocal sort of tone that he's doing. I think also the other thing is you don't tend to get. Well, I mean, you still do get a lot of these big sort of digital analog boards. It's an oxymoron, digital analog. But yeah, the traditional slider boards, which are, I mean, that's, I don't know how many sliders were on there. That's a huge studio with all those different rack mounts around the back, synths, keyboards, etc. Not all of those keyboards and synths will be set up at the same time, but they are there for musicians to work on parts. You don't have to go in because they're already sound isolated. They can go straight into the mixer. And then you'll have a separate vocal room. So basically what you'll probably have in a studio like that is a couple of big live rooms, a vocal room, and then obviously you've got the mixing room, playback room, which they were in for the bulk of their time to have just listened to the playback. And they'll have a multiple speakers, a couple at the top, down the front there to kind of get an overall, and obviously you can get some cans or stroke headphones for if you want to get a bit more of a close, detailed, isolated listen rather than room listen. But you want to listen to on as many different types as possible. So I'll probably have a couple of different varieties of speaker types so you can get a different vibe. And obviously it's down to the sound treatment of the room so you don't get any of these sort of dull spots or dead spots within the room. Apart from the smoking thing, it was just interesting to see how so they're using condenser mics rather than dynamic mics from what I can tell from the room. Again, couldn't quite see on the camera what type of microphone they're using. Different types of mics you'll get. So dynamic mics are, where have I got some dynamic mics? I'm sure I've got a few down here. I usually have something knocking around in the room. Where are all my mics on today? So you've got your dynamic mics like these sort of things. So these are dynamic mics, Shure SM58. So you'll see these mainly for live. These have got a single microphone right in the front. Take that off. So right on the end. So audio, you want that straight at you, straight like that. If you try to sing it like that, you will pick up some sound, but it won't be as clear. So you'll get a real dull spot, and as it goes forward, you'll get a real kind of clarity. So this is straight in. You'll see these are really robust mics. You'll see these used primarily live, although a lot of rock singers will use them as well in the studio. And then you've got these sort of mics, which are kind of condenser mics. And these have got all round, so you can kind of, you'll see a lot of these kind of just hanging and people kind of singing from either different sides. Now these are really sensitive. These pick up lots of noise. They'll pick up a lot of room noise. So usually with something like that, they'll be set up in a live room in front of an amp or something like that, where there's no one else in there. So all it's getting is the amp signal. There's no person in the room. The person will actually probably be in the mixing room playing and listening back to their amp through the speakers, effectively their amp modeling or reamping as well, getting a clean signal and then reamping through the desk. So there's some different ones, and then you've got other ones like, again, this is a this is actually a dynamic mic, this one. So again, this is all focus of going straight in, so it's slightly different to the SM58, but in the same sort of category. But it's used quite primarily as a, depending on the frequencies and what it's set up for. But that one's more for vocal recordings, etc., like dialect recordings versus singing. Kind of went off topic there about talking about microphones, which is a bit odd. But interesting to see them working on it. But I would have liked to have seen a little bit more about their processes if I could have. But nice to go check out someone in the studio. But yes, smoke in the studio is not something we'd recommend, but who's going to say no to Snoop Dogg in their studio? Anyway, great. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please do subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share. Now, of course, Sound Musician Reacts.